To me, floaters are one of the toughest things to work on. You can't really teach the technique too much after a basic level. It's a lot of just touch work and feel. But then there are also a lot deeper things that go into it. Things that you never even think about. The angle you take into it. The pickup points. Learning how to rotate into that floater. Going off 1 foot or 2 feet fluidly. So all these things we train in this workout, and even if I'm not teaching them with words, they're learning through these games that they're gonna play. So check it out and let me know what you think.
All right, you can go drip moves, whatever. Whenever I say go, you're getting it up as quick as you can into that float. Go!
So I like this one a lot, especially as a warm-up drill, mainly because it focuses on unpredictability and picking it up with different pickup points. It's not the same floater every time. Sometimes you're moving to the right, to the left. Sometimes it's up high when you pick it up. Sometimes it's a little bit lower. So this is going to help us get comfortable with different pickup points, different timings, and overall different types of shots on this 2 foot floater. We're building touch, we're getting warm, etc.
Bank it in. Sudden death, let's go. Yes. Keep no defense here. One from the block, one from this hash mark, one from this hash mark, one from this hash mark, one from right inside 3-point line. Whoever can go through that first, we won't go alternating hands. Alternating sides wins.
So especially in my group workouts, we do a lot of stuff with defense, live work. But I always make sure that we also get our quote unquote traditional reps up. Especially for something like floaters where it's such a touch-based shot. I do think this is something where we need a lot of reps to get comfortable with it. But notice here how I'm really exaggerating how far back they're going. They start off with a couple easy ones, then they move back and back and even further back because I want to exaggerate it. I want to create difficulty. These guys are all college players, so they're comfortable shooting it from the block. And in anything, even when we're just getting our reps up, I want to make sure that I'm challenging in some form or fashion.
You made all of them?
Yeah, that one and that one, right?
You made hash mark and right inside 3-point line?
Right here.
From both sides?
Yeah.
You're tossing it to me. Actually, don't even worry about that. I'll toss it straight to you. I'm going to step one side or the other. You just go the opposite side. So it's like attacking a quick closeout. You're getting into a flow outside of the paint. All right, so wherever you want to, Malik, you gotta go around me the other way.
All right.
Okay, so for example, we'll go slow motion here.
Side, you go on your side, basically.
Right, exactly. Yeah, 100%.
So
slow-mo for sure. I'll toss it here, boom. Malik's gotta go around this way as fast as he can, contest that shot. All right, it'll be a lighter contest, but should be able to get there. Oh yeah, oh, got them both. I'll take that one.
Then as we start to add in defense, I'm using this setup for a couple reasons. Number one, it makes it realistic. It's attacking a closeout. It's a simple way to get into your floater that you're gonna see a good amount in a game. Number two, it creates a defensive chase down, but nothing crazy. They definitely feel that pressure of the defender, but it's not like they're fighting to get that shot up. And then lastly, it's a defensive drill. They gotta think quickly, adjust their angle, and get back to that offensive play.
Sorry, one, you're putting defense in jail right here. Whenever you cross that yellow 3-point line downhill, you can get into anything you want to on a one-on-two situation. So now I'm stepping up, obviously, short guy. I'll play a big man kind of role right here. You're getting into anything you want to. Don't worry about it being outside the paint or anything. Just get into a floater, Malik. You can block that, whatever, from behind. All right. Yep.
In this one here, we're just recreating a situation that these guys are easily gonna see a few times a game. Defender on their back. In a game, whether they're holding them off or not, doesn't really matter. It's just the fact that they have a defender chasing them, probably off a pick and roll, and then attacking into the third layer of defense, which is that shot blocker. So I'm giving them a ton of freedom here to get into any type of floater pretty much. And as you'll see, they don't shoot the same shot twice. Every single rep is different, so they're really getting different looks, learning how to read this situation, and it's a tough situation to deal with sometimes. It's one on two.
Nice. Two all around. Oh yeah, oh yeah. So you're across your body here, a couple feet outside the paint. You're really trying to rip this ball into two steps, getting into a floater, jumping as far as you can with that. So really try to kind of fade towards that opposite sideline over here, where you're one, two, fading with it. That side's gonna be a little awkward, because it's kind of coming towards I guess your right shoulder, same thing on this side.
Then we're back to a little bit of reps-based work. I like to think about creating a wave with our live work in these workouts. So we may start low with not much, just getting reps up, or we may start high, going straight into that live work with defense. Then throughout the workout, we're going up and down to make sure we're covering the whole spectrum. But again, it's always got to be a challenge, which is why I'm adding this rotation into it to help them work on finding the basket and then dealing with rotation on those floaters.
We'll go two variations of this. I'll start inside without a dribble. I'm tossing it to myself here. Whenever I go, that's when you go. So not whenever I throw, but whenever I go. All right, so I'll be here. I can wait. Then I'm getting into it. Same idea. All right.
This next one is a sneaky good drill for a couple reasons. Number one, we're implementing that rotation again. Number two, it teaches them or trains them to monitor that defender chasing, their angle or speed, and then shoot that floater accordingly. And then number three, I think for whatever reason, shooting floaters off the catch is one of the hardest things to do. You don't have that rhythm, so this is training that ability for when we need it.
And most of what we did at the beginning, let's say you're on defense right here, you're as close or as far from me as you want to be, but your hands are on your hips. All right, I'm going back and forth here. Let's say every single dribble has to be a move. So it's switching hands here, 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 here. Whenever I start to shoot that ball, his hands can leave his hips. He's trying to block that shot. So I got to get off really quick off 2 feet. Oh, got him. One. Let's say a fake, if they get their hands off their hips, that's an extra point.
Now circling almost back to what we started with at the beginning, but we're making it live. Plus, I want them to add in some fakes, some unpredictability, different pickup points. Drills like this are always super engaging. They get players involved. And this is exactly what we want out of a workout, right? Yes, maybe there's time to get monotonous reps up.
Oh, got him, that's one.
But when they're fully engaged in the workout, this is the best thing you can ask for.
Dribble. So instead of tossing it out, you're just here. You got two dribbles. You don't have to take two, but you can to get into a floater in the paint. All right, same idea. Whenever you leave, defense leaves as well. First one to three. Obviously, everything's a floater. Nice. Good patience. I'm tossing it to either hand. I'm on defense. I'm tossing it to either hand. You're just spinning with the ball. So if I toss it here, you spin that way. I'm sprinting down. You can't go inside the paint. So let's say you can't even land inside the paint. If you land inside the paint, nope.
Then lastly, I'm just letting them loose to play out of it. All the different qualities that we've worked on in the session, they come back into play. They can use certain tools. They don't have to. They got the most freedom in this drill. And that's exactly why I like to end on it. So as always, thank you guys so much for tuning in. Hopefully you learned something from this video, a technique, a drill, an idea, something that you can take with you and apply into your training or your game. Go get to work on this. As always, make sure to follow me on Instagram at By Any Means Basketball. Tap in with our virtual academy, which has a bunch of drills like this, and stay tuned.